Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons.
In this video, we will talk about various vasoactive compounds. As per the name, these are basically the compounds that act on blood vessels. See, mostly their action on blood vessels is just a small part of a broader physiological or pathological phenomenon. For example, angiotensin II causing vasoconstriction is just one step in renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system for regulation of blood pressure. So, rather than just memorizing these factors and their effects, it's better that you take note of the context as well. That way, the topic will be more interesting. Now let's begin. First factor is something that you already know very well. It's epinephrine. When the sympathetic nervous system is activated, it stimulates the adrenal medulla and causes the release of epinephrine. It directly enters the blood and spreads throughout the body. In most places, it causes vasoconstriction. So blood pressure is increased. But at some places, like in blood vessels to the heart and skeletal muscles, it causes vasodilatation. This helps in carrying out intense physical activity, which is mostly why the sympathetic system was activated in first place. So this was epinephrine. His partner norepinephrine is also secreted under the same circumstances, but from nerve endings. Among the two, norepinephrine is a more powerful vasoconstrictor because it does not have vasodilator action that is seen at some places with epinephrine. Thus, the duo of epinephrine and norepinephrine do a double attack on blood vessels, one marching through the circulating blood and the other through the nerves. So this was about epinephrine and norepinephrine. Next is angiotensin II. This one is also a powerful vasoconstrictor. It is synthesized as a part of the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system when blood pressure is decreased. It causes constriction of arterioles, which contributes to rise the blood pressure. Next, vasopressin. It is secreted from posterior pituitary when plasma osmolarity increases. Or in simple words, it is secreted when the body water is decreasing. Its main job is the retention of water during urine formation to restore the water level in the body. Okay, but where is its action on blood vessels? Well, at concentrations that we see in the most physiological conditions, it does not produce much effects on blood vessels. But in extreme conditions, like hemorrhagic shock, it's secreted in large quantities. In such conditions, it causes vasoconstriction, which contributes to a transient increase in blood pressure. So this was vasopressin. The factors we saw thus far mainly cause vasoconstriction. Now let's see the factors causing vasodilation. Here first we have histamine. It's released by mast cells. Yeah, I know they are called mast cells. It's released by mast cells and basophils in response to injury and inflammation. It causes vasodilation and increases capillary permeability. This produces edema. This effect is prominent especially during allergic reaction. So this was histamine. Next we have kinins. As this topic is not touched upon anywhere else, we will go into a bit more detail here. So get ready for a drama. Kinins are a group of peptides with various activities. For example, bradykinin. They are produced by breakdown of kininogens. This breakdown is catalyzed by enzymes called kallikreins. Kallikreins. Normally, this enzyme is inactive. Conditions like tissue inflammation cause their activation. The enzyme then catalyzes the synthesis of kinins. The kinins cause vasodilation, and ultimately, they are degraded by kininase enzymes. If we make a TV series on kinins, this would be season 1. Season 2 takes the story further from kininase enzymes. These enzymes come in varieties like kininase 1 and kininase 2. And kininase 2 is nothing but the angiotensin converting enzyme which converts angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 is a powerful vasoconstrictor, as we just saw a few minutes back. Do you see the smartness of angiotensin converting enzyme? It produces vasoconstrictors and destroys dilators. He must be in love with vasoconstriction. This would be the climax of season 2. But the show is not over yet. Season 3 takes us back to the origin story of kallikrein. The activation of kallikrein involves clotting factor 12, which is also called Hagman factor. And he in turn is activated by plasmin. If you are enjoying the show, you can learn more about plasmin in the video on fibrinolysis. But for now, let's stop here. So, these were the top 5 vasoactive compounds. Some honorable mentions that could not make to this list are nitric oxide, serotonin, endothelin, atrial natriuretic peptide, some prostaglandins, and even ions like calcium, potassium, magnesium, hydrogen, and carbon dioxide. In summary, important vasoconstrictors are epinephrine, norepinephrine, angiotensin II, and vasopressin, and vasodilators are histamine and kinins. For watching the video until the end, I have a special bonus for you. See, as such, this topic is not important as far as basic understanding of physiology is concerned. After all, it's just a compilation of blood vessels related information from different broader concepts. So if you learn these individual concepts well, you don't particularly miss anything. Then why the books like Guyton, Boron, and even I am making the topic out of it? The answer is a learning principle called interleaving. In simple words, interleaving is going through the same information in different ways. It's like wandering in the same area, but by taking different routes. It improves your learning. Here we have done the same thing. Usually we learn all these concepts independently. But looking from the perspective of blood vessels brings them together. This way, you can see the connections better, so understanding and memory improves. So whenever you see a possibility of practicing interleaving, I encourage you to do that. It may not add new knowledge, but it will solidify your existing knowledge. A very simple place where you can practice interleaving is tables. If you go through the tables in the same way every time, you are not taking benefit of interleaving. Try to go in alternate ways as well. To know more about interleaving, just Google it. It will help you in your study. For now, I am concluding the video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.